Patnaik sir. So I will start his class. May it will started little delay. No problem. Sir can continue further. Okay. So there is no time limit. So as long as sir will not complete the course, so to, sir can continue. So I welcome to sir.
Yes. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir.
This is
good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. This is Teko Patnaik. And today's class is very interesting one. This is of rural development paper 102, and I will be starting the unit 3. So in the unit 3, you will find the theme of the rural development, how the rural development is very prominent, and particularly in the rural mountains.
संतोष सर
हाँ सर
म्यूट करो तुम म्यूट करो
म्यूट करो
तुम अबे सुबह होती हेलो
आया कंटिन्यू करो सर
हाँ राइट today's class is something different from all other papers. This and this is about the employment generation for the rural youth. In most of the cases, the moment we say rural development, everybody is anxious to know what sort of development takes place, particularly in the field of rural development. But the rural development is one of the major subject which provides not only the directives of development of self, the village, the road connectivity, the housing, what not, everything, but particularly this paper deals with the employment generation scheme. So this employment generation scheme, through different schemes, like you may say that why this rural development deals with the employment. The employment actually the most one of the important aspects for the development. Where there is no money, the development becomes very either slow or not interested by the public, or not in involved the people's participation, or the overall the rural development program itself will become something defective. That is why the schemes like Prime Minister's Rozgar Yojana, which has been established in our country, throughout the country, which generates the employment opportunities for the rural youth. Actually, what the rural youth is concerned about this, the main thing is globally, the situation is no different. Small or medium enterprises generate 78% of all jobs in Japan, and 69% jobs in Korea. Keeping that in the example, the so-called the Indian government also introduced a scheme like with self-dependency, self-employability, or skill development, or you can say the rural youth employment generation program. So the Prime Minister's Rozgar Yojana, it actually provides about 7 lakhs enterprises and consequential employment for more than 1 million educated unemployed youth in the last 4 years. So the here the eighth 5-year plan, initially in 1994-95, it has been in operational in both urban as well as the rural areas. You'll be surprising how this much of this volume of youth are getting employability in 9-5 years plan, with the plan target of 11 lakh beneficiaries, with an annual target of 2.20 lakhs beneficiaries in PMRY. It including 10th 5-year plan also, it has increased to 11 lakhs. So like that, it goes on increasing from year to year. but how the scheme is lucrative. In fact, everybody is interested, but they probably due to the wages or the remuneration maybe a little bit lesser, or it is not that lucrative for educated youth. That is how the program might have, I can't say failed, but somehow reluctant. But there is a possibility of surveillance or the existence for once to meet the basic needs. So the beneficiary eligibility criteria is PMRY is a bank operated scheme for creating enterprise and is meant for the educated unemployed youth throughout the country in both rural and urban areas. The idea behind this scheme is both rural and urban, wherever the youth is there, they should be employed first. The nation's most important concern is that employability in the age group of 18 to 35. That was the criteria given. And the states Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, northeastern regions, Uttarakhand, the upper age limit was extended up to 40 years. Similarly, the educated unemployed who belongs to scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, ex-servicemen, physically handicapped or women, the upper age limit is extended up to 45 years. But today, surprisingly, we find most of the people from the rural areas, they migrate to different neighboring states or the urban areas or the cities, metropolitan cities, because probably the Prime Minister's Rozgar Yojana, PMRY, is not that lucrative or suitable for the Indian, I mean the rural based people, because everybody expects more. So the limitations are there for the government program. Since the Prime Minister's Rozgar Yojana comes under the government scheme, the scheme provides you the minimum financial sanctions. So it cannot give you the as much as you demand or as per the requirements of the market, and also the scheme is not attractive. Particularly the women will be paid lesser, or the amount may be sufficient for them. For the men, they may need more, and the age criteria is there. Everybody cannot be employable or employed in this scheme. So only the 8th class passed candidates will be preferred. Education is again required. So some illiterate, innocent people may not be considered, and it's a recognized approved institution for the for the 6 months they have to undergo a training-like thing in skill development, so that they will be considered under the scheme of Prime Minister's Rozgar Yojana. So it's a residency. In order to eligible under the scheme, it is necessary that conditions that beneficiary is a permanent resident of that area of the village, at least 3 years, there is a relaxation for this condition for the married men of Meghalaya and other married women from the other country or a state or a district like. So for both the categories, the residency criteria applies to these spouses or in-laws. Again, the reservation. The reservation is meant for the weaker sections. Preference is to be given to women. The scheme envisages 22.5% reservation for the SC, ST and 27% for the other backward classes, OBC. In case of SC, ST, OBC candidates are not available, the state, union territory government can consider other categories for candidates under PMRY. So this is a very lucrative scheme where the rural areas have got an opportunity to lead their life at their own village, at their doorsteps. But in most of the cases, the program was by failed or not publicized or not familiar or not by the people are not accepting it. There may be so many other reasons. let us not go by that drawbacks, but we will see the positive side of that scheme. The project cost subsidy and marginal money facility is also there. So the scheme is good, but maybe at the time of its implementation, there are some problems bottlenecks are arising. Most of the rural youth, they may not be knowing. अधिकांश क्षेत्र रे गाँव गहर जो युवक मैंने रोचन्ति से माने ए स्कीम विषय रे विशेष करके जानी नांति जदि बा जानी चन्ति से माने ठीक रे यार कौन नियम केते पैसा से पाइबे का पको जीवा को पड़िबो केम तो दरखास्त करिया पड़िबो एम तांको या द्वारा घरे बसे बसे के को स्कीम गडा तांको पे उपयुक्त एगडा सब न जानी के से माने कोन करन्ति ना जल्दबाजी रे पळान्ति शहर को से जे बहुत असुविधा रे सम्मुखन कलन्ति बा तांको निज गां एवं राज्य छाड़ी की अन्य राज्य को पळान्ति केवल दि पैसा अधिक पाइबे बोली अथवा सेठी भल चाकरी खंडे पाइबा पढ़ाते कि स्कीम रे प्रोजेक्ट भी अच्छे प्रोजेक्ट कॉस्ट भी अच्छे सब्सिडी भी अच्छे मार्जिन मनी भी अच्छे जदि युवक मैंने चाहती एकाठी तीन चार जन दस जन मिसिक गोटे प्रोजेक्ट बनाते प्रोजेक्ट टा को केमी से निजे दायित्व नहीं कि चलेबे से गाँ गहर हिं भल भल स्कीम गुड़ा से बाहर करके चले पारे सरकार जेहेतु यहाँ सरकारी विशेष ध्यान नदे लोक भावते हाँ ये मैंने कौन पैसा देवे गोटे प्रोजेक्ट प्रोजेक्टर दि लक्ष टा से दिखते छोटा इंडस्ट्री पे सर्विसेस लक्ष टा दिखती बिजनेस सेक्टर में ये गुट सब आम कर इंडिविजुआल एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप हिसाब से पी एम आर वाई जदि आम दि चार पांच जन मिसिक हायर कॉस्ट जब करवा मैक्सिमम दस लक्ष टा ऋण मिल एंड एटा क्वारी किन में आमको दरकार सांगे सांगे दस हजार दस लक्ष कोड़े लक्ष जहाँफल कि आम पूरा मालामाल महाजन हो दैट इज हाउ दि स्कीम हेज मिजरेबली वेदर फेल और नॉट अट्रैक्टिव और मोस्ट ऑफ द यूथ आर नॉट कमिंग फॉरवर्ड टू अवेल द बेनिफिट और द पर्टिकुलर दिस योजना secondly not only youth even men and women but the same scheme is also extended for self help groups you know self help group mahila mane gote gaare 10 ru 20 jana 15 ru 20 ru mahila mane jodi ekati hoonte gote group bolya karante aa se mane sabu masare gote jagare meeting kari ki tankar jo विभिन्न कार्यक्रम गुट जो आग को निर घरे कामधाम सारी किसी समय जो सेल्फ एम्प्लॉयमेंट बा सेल्फ फाइनेंसिंग बा सेल्फ हेल्प ग्रुप गुड़ा जो जरिया किसी करते देन इट्स आल्सो ए सिग्निफिकेंट एलिजिबिलिटी क्राइटेरिया लेड अंडर द स्कीम वॉलंटियर एटा वॉलंटियर आसीजीव जिते से कमेबे से और जी भल से रोजगार करेंगे से पैसा तक सो पंदर आई मीन पाँच रु कोड़े एजुकेटेड वुमेन मैंने जब एकाठी हूँ तो झील पिला हो कि शाशु हो कि बो हो जे भी होता कहीं से गाँव महिला होने जब गोटे ग्रुप करेंगे अपर सिलिंग नो अपर सिलिंग मानने ऋण भी नहीं पारे बैंक जरिया रे एवं महिला कोष बोली गोटे भारत सरकार गोटे ऑर्गेनाइजेशन अच्छे से लोन नहीं पारे आने जहाँ चाहिए तापरेंगे जमती कि पुराणा मानने दस कोड़े वर्ष तले सबूतक एस एच जी ग्रुप केवल गोटे काम करते कौन ना पांपड़ बेल ना बड़ी पकाओ कि आचार बुमा खोली बुण कि जहा जा मिलूची फॉरेस्ट ये नेचुरल रिसोर्सेस ताकु नै कि किछि काम कर जेंति कि बाउंस बाउंस केरी हेतिब केटा आर्टिकल ए सब से माने करथले किंतु वर्तमान द ट्रेंड हैज बीन चेंज्ड the modern civilization made the schemes very liberal. Whether you are educated or uneducated, every woman is eligible to come under this scheme. They can do wonders, not only by physical labor, but intellectually. If a woman group forms every once in a month, takes a decision of good business promoting activities, then the SSG group becomes the top or the most beneficiary organization in the society. They have to think two things. One is, what will be benefited to their group? They should work in the interest of the group first. Second, what are the loans available? Who are the banks offering them the loans, subsidiary, and also the schemes for different these things? Sometimes state government also gives matching grant, subsidy or whatever it is for their better scope. And the only thing is the time surplus with the each woman that should be properly utilized sitting at their doorsteps. So this is the most interesting, and in the India it has proved a miracle that a woman can do the best than a man, and the production should be very, very important aspect, like rural based artisans, rural based productions, rural based natural resources availability product, schemes. And a woman thinks whatever she likes, not only in the sector of business, but in the sector of promoting the education, promoting the fruit products, different food products like hotel industry, hospitality, tourism, and vehicle transportation. All these things, the decisions can be taken across the table by the leading women group, and they can invest the money which they have collected, and they go on multiplying that amount every year, and they should be well trained in accounts, and they know how to make a ledger and how to make a cash book and accountability to be maintained. So the strong and the best women SSG group is the best example for the rural development, for the village development, or you can say the development of that particular group, those who are contributing and devoting their time and doing wonderful job, and they will be an example to the other neighboring villages. So this is how self-help groups also comes under the same scheme, but in the shape of projects, subsidiary and margin money, and they can have a group meeting like, and they can also contribute their services. So rural development is not a weak. Rural development is not losing anything. Rural development is the common platform for each and every citizen to develop his own career. And rural development is such a subject, one can do wonders sitting at their home, and not necessary to run after here and there, but just doing something development of miracle. So the real research or innovation starts from the mother's lap at their own village. So this is how we have to think carefully and go ahead with the limited the resources available by the government, by different organizations. This is how the self-help groups and the Prime Minister's Rozgar Yojana, this works mostly for 3 to 7 years after the initial, the repayment schedule will start from 3 to 7 years, and it will become revolution fund. So the fund will be going on increasing every year, but if you carefully handle it, and accountability is there. So this is how the rural development, the subject is very, very interesting one, and the implementation involvement of the officers identified is selection of specific allocations, identification of the support system required by the beneficiary, afford service and close liaison with the banks and other local agencies concerned with the industry, trade and service sector, the district level task force committees, the facilities the facilitating these activities. The task force comprises a chairman who is a senior officer of the implementing agency, preferably the head of the agency, that is the general manager, the district industries center director in the case of SISI, external director industries and director of industries of the deputy commissioner of district, other members of the task force or the representatives, and also the representatives of lead bank, lead two leading banks, district employment officer, one of the member of the district SISI, other implementing agencies, one officer as a member secretary to be nominated by the chairman of the task force, and also the chairman may be co-opt one or more members from reputed non-governmental organizations, then women concerned. These are all the officers, those who are supporting for this noble Prime Minister's Rozgar Yojana. And so it is a 100% government owned organization. How best we can develop it with all the supporting officials inducted or included or having role in this promotion of self-employment or the employability of the rural youth. So here, women concern is again, it is something different. The women concern programs, they have their own way and they can develop whatever is better for them. The women associated with the welfare of women to the meetings, instructed inviting women associations and also the task force committees, besides the lead bank and leading banks, other implementing banks, also they attend the district task force continuing meetings on a rotational basis. Then comes responsibility. So here, the women, particularly from Indian culture and also from the angle of Odisha, if you take it as a challenge, you will find some peculiarities here in implementation. Most of the women, they don't come out of the house because they still we have a traditional method of living. So most of the women, they think this is not my job. So why should I intervene it? And some women, though they are interested, the situations does not permit them. The family may be against for such deeds, or some people are too rich, they don't want to participate further in any of the employability schemes. And some bad, needy persons, those who are very, very poor and they are interested, but they are not afford to join, or they cannot do the job satisfactorily because of their innocence, ignorance, illiteracy, and poverty. So these things should be removed from the minds of the women, particularly in the at the village level. So the lot of awareness is required through information, education, and entertainment process of spending their time lavishly among the women within their area of specific, then the program will be a successful one. So the SSG groups is an exemplary, exceptionally for the women, by the women, to the women. So the schemes are many, not necessary that they have to do a particular job or they are compelled to do a particular category of the work. So they can choose the best business, lucrative money earning or money fetching, or within a short period, more money process. All these things get together, it can be developed at the grassroots level by just joining hands together. So this is the Johar Rozgar Yojana. Let us promote the scheme once again so that no unemployability will be there. At least people will be benefited. Of course, they are educated people. They may be reluctant to work at the lower remuneration at their doorsteps. So district PMRY committees also they are formed nowadays. So in the district PMRY, everybody is aware that it has got a resource allocation funding for doing different activities in every financial year. The budget is being allocated particularly to take up these things. Subsidy is also pronounced and announced. The entrepreneurial activities also designed, or the rural youth can join easily in different schemes of their choice. So these are all meant for the, not only for the women, for the rural youth. So the youth force is well protected, I can say. The rural development studies, it needs more popularized in the villages, and particularly the opinion leaders, the panchayat members and sarpanch, BDOs and all other related public opinion should be gathered, and everybody should be motivated to make this program success. So here, since government agencies are involved, like CEO DRDA is there, district collector himself is the chairman, and district employment officer is there, lead bank managers also there. So it's a forceful approach by the government, and it's an acceptable, very good initiative for the rural youth at the panchayat level. So here, and the field activities also can be undertaken or guided by the principals of engineering colleges, polytechnics, industrial institutions, and district statistical officer, district education officer, and also the training representatives of banks. All this cooperation and coordination will be there once we look into it and take up this particular assignment on the challenging basis. So here, the most interesting thing is the rural development is protected by all means. Even the after independence also, the agriculture, the banking sector, and also the industrial sector, everybody, they join hands for the better rural developmental programs. So the only thing is, when we speak about the rural development, always we think of a village where there is no facilities, where there is no road to lead, and there is no life at all, and no commercial establishments, no raw material. All these things will come into our mind. But once you establish, try to improve that particular village or the infrastructure available there. Slowly, every village will come out of with some uncue or the very interesting products or the industries, whatever they may we need. So this is the challenge between the youth, rural youth, and the rural development professionals, as well as the bureaucrats or the government employees, including the people's representatives at the grassroots level. For all these things, the major thing is training. Unless one person is trained, he cannot do anything. Once the training is given to undergo entrepreneurial developmental training, 15 to 20 working days for a project, and the person will become perfect. And the industry sector, rupees 1,000 per case, inclusive of stipend, 300 per day. These are all the old statistics given, but we can revise it from time to time, and we can see that you earn by learning and exhibit your skills in which field you are interested. And that can lead a major, a good result oriented for the better prospects of your career. So the training at the rural base may be one of the interesting this thing. The PMRY conducts these training programs exclusively for the youth, and these training programs are also certified, are backed to the different categories of people, those who are suffering in the society. So the special training courses exclusively for SCs, STs, and women entrepreneurs will be more, it is already there existing, and it should be explored and availed by each and every rural mass, so that in future there won't be lagging behind of skill, and the entrepreneurship once you gain, you are the best pathfinder for future generation. So this is the scheme linked in the evergreen. It goes on continuing. No way you can stop it. Not only the financial assistance, but also you will get a thrilling, and your knowledge is recognized, and you will be the best among the lot. So basically, in this lesson, we can teach. I mean, you can learn some more things, and the other things like the automatically you will gain the potentiality of the courses, different courses. Where there is will, there is a way. You can find out your career of your own, and at the same time, you can change the scenario of the village by introducing new schemes, new industries, new initiatives, and a bread earning process for the future generation. So this is all about the what's called a rural employment generation programs. REGP is also there, and it is also linked with Prime Minister's Rozgar Yojana. REGP is also the same rural base. For example, the village and khadi industries here, the industries, public sector mainly, involved in this, every major panchayat should have a public sector undertaking where the industry should grown up for the benefit of the rural youth. So the activity is a continuous process. Let us not close this subject only once a person gets some job and he's well educated, I mean well trained, and he's carrying on his business, let others should suffer. No, it should be a continuous process. One should learn and teach the other. So learning and teaching is a cycle form, one after another it takes place. Here again, you have a enough scope as rural employment generation program. We call it as REGP. What is this REGP? REGP is nothing but it's a combined together undertaking, a public sector undertaking, like where the high power committees are formed. Rural employment generation programs, it started in April 1995, with its objective is to generate employability to millions of the rural youth throughout the country. Though here the major public sectors like steel industries, village and khadi industries, and so the institutions like reputed, these are all mainly meant to promote this particular program. Project may be costing 25% of the cost will be borne by the state government or the central government. There is a margin money. The project cost may be 10 lakhs to 25 lakhs, and the marginal money is 25%. So if one can start easily a project depending on the local areas and the SC, ST, OBC, women, physically handicapped, taking everybody under consideration, a small units of projects can be started so that the employability will be within the control. Banks also will sanction 90% of the project cost in the case of general category, and borrowers of 95% of the project cost are beneficiaries. And here the margin money is there. If you repay the amount, you'll get again the loan, or the margin money is given to you for your betterment. So these are all the schemes. These are all the God-gifted schemes. But how many of us we know? We always think about the white-collar job in a town or a city where we can lead a happy life, we think. But we neglect the real fruits given by the government or given in the different schemes under the rural development. So this is more interesting thing. And most of the public sector banks, they are with the rural mass, so they are bound to, I mean, they are meant for the development of the rural areas. So everybody will join hands for the better understanding of leading projects and other things. And every citizen of India has got a right to have his own choices, entrepreneurship or a business or an industry of his choice. So here, the most interesting thing is the funds needs to be rotated. Suppose simply you get the loan from the bank, keep it in a closed almirah, it is of no use. So it should be utilized properly, creating one job, the target fixed, and the average amount of funds required for creating one job, the budget for the program is finalized and placed before the parliament. Funds are allotted for marginal margin money, subsidiary, entrepreneurship, development, training, marketing, including exhibitions, festivals, awareness camps, and publicity and promotional activities. So any activity, whichever you want to do it, it should be properly designed. So without planning, you cannot do it. आमे जदि स्वार्थ देखिबा एटा मु करबी मोरी पई करबी मो निज पई करबी आ जहा आसीबो लाभ मु एकुटिया नेबी ताले केबे भी हेई परबो नाही जदि बा होबो सेटा कोठी ना कोठी बंद हे जीवो काहे कि वन मैन शो इज ऑलवेज रिस्ट्रिक्टेड टू हिज ओन फोर वॉल्स इफ इट इज ए ग्रुप ग्रुप वे ग्रुप विलेजर्स बाइंड टुगेदर जदि आमे समस्ते मिसिंग जदि करबा जति कि युवक अच्छा समस्त जदि आम प्रचार करवा प्रसारण करवा लोकलोचन को आणवापर आम देखा जे या भितर आमर के स्वार्थ अच्छे केक मान केवक युवती मान उपकृत हो पारे और गाँव उन्नति हो पारे आपर सरकार कौन दौची आम सरकार कौन करपत्ति जदि आम चलवा सबुतक स्कीम गुड़ा बहुत बढ़िया स्कीम कितु अभाव मान इनफर्मेशन पॉवर्टी आम ठीक सचेतनता हो पार ना बाम को सूचना ठीक समय मिल पार ना जहाँ फल कि आम सबुद गरीब हो रही आम कहते हैं वी आर रूरल इवेन टुडे इवेन टुमारो इवेन फर लाइफ लॉन्ग इवेन आफ्टर 70 इयर्स ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंस वी विल बी पुअर एंड पुअरर सो दिस इज नॉट एन एक्सक्यूज द एक्सक्यूज इज सपोज इफ यू कम आउट विद अ डिटर्मिनेशन Everybody is there to help you. It's all government programs, not somebody's Marwadi program or one individual's approach program. So these things are approachable, can be done, and we should have determination. Where there is will, there is a way. Ame ette paatha poduche, ame rural development jo chitrama ba. सर्टिफिकेट इन रूरल डेवलपमेंट कहतु पीजी डिप्लोमा इन रूरल डेवलपमेंट कि अदर डेवलपमेंट मास्टर डिग्री इन पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन मार्केटिंग सबुतक पाठ दिज आर ऑल रीच टू स्ट्रेंथन आवर डेवलपमेंटल एक्टिविटीज आम पाठ पढ़ु कौन पाई जस्ट कीपिंग द क्वालिफिकेशन एज योर एंड ऑफ द नेम एड इट इन एंड ऑफ द नेम नो वी आर reading or studying or achieving a degrees to, for the betterment of service oriented to service to the service to the public is service to the nation and the service to the god so with that intention let us together join hands so that we can achieve the targets given by the government not only government by the national employability or national youth policies and all So if one program is successful, most of us will be leading and getting very good results and will be enjoying it. So this is all about the schemes meant for different schemes meant for the rural development. Without these schemes, we have no life. If without employability, there is no use of studying or reading or spending time. If there is an employment, employment opportunities, what sort of employability is there. The schemes are meant good for us unless we know we cannot achieve our targets. Because we never bother the government schemes, it is just in the cold stories. And nobody is there to ask the government, these schemes are there, why don't you give it to us? They starve or they beg or they borrow or they go away from the house, but never demand their own rights available at their doorsteps. Even the some of the youth, they even never ask the sarpanch what the gram panchayat is doing and what are the programs meant for the village development, because we are not bothered. We are bothered only one-sided. So this is how the rural development has become one of the, I can't say neglected, but it is one of the silent subject matter, though it has got a very good scope of earning. So let me stop here with the employment generation. Now I will go for the Rashtriya Mahila Kosh. It is based on the rural developmental activities. We can go through different types of schemes given to the women entrepreneurs or the financial aspects for the women organization, where from they can draw loans of in different schemes for the survival, not only survival, for the development of women in our country. So here there are two things to decide. The most interesting thing is what is Rashtriya Mahila Kosh. This program is very interesting. It started in 1950s and it has got a microfinance scheme, we can call it as. And here the most interesting thing is we have World Bank assistance. In 1995, the World Bank estimated most developing countries, the formal financial system reaches only 25% of the economically active population. So the bottom 75% have no access to financial services apart from the money lenders. In India too, the formal financial institutions have not been made able to reach the poor households, particularly women in the recognized sector. Overheads result in high cost of small loans. This is nothing but, dekhuche aajikali gaan golre odhikansho mahila mane kichhi loan koranti nahi ba bank ku janti nahi kimba tankar konosi abashyakata bhi nathae financial ye boli. Tenu they spend their time, they depend on the on men folk. World Bank gote assessment korthila je kebal 75% loan gula rural area re jai parne ba khorche hei parne kebal 25% tankara loan shahar anchal re diya hoti aw mahila mane basic agrah nuhanti je se paisa gula kemiti kharcha karibe ebong कौन काम लगे कौन कि प्रकार इंडस्ट्रीज कि एंटरप्रेन्योर्स करे उन्नति हम ये सब नहीं कि अधिकांश केस रे कौन हुए ना महिला कोष केवल ना को रही 1950s रु आरंभ होलानी आश्चर्य कथा एपर्त कहीं भी जानी नहीं इटा केवल महिला मानी होतेटा महिला ये महिला कोष रु साज्य नहीं पार्टी बा कौन सी लोन बातंकर विपत्ति वाले ऐसे साज़ जो लोड चंगे तो ना ऐसा उधर चैलेंजिंग विषय है जेतो हमें जाने ने बाह हमें काकु जानो ने बस आवश्यकता पड़ूना जिते शेष मुहूर्त जी गोटे महिला चाहब कि दरकार कौटे जीव कौन करवल बैंक पचारे बुले बुल तार समय टाक कटौती तार जो अवशिष्ट समय टाइम माइक्रो फाइनेंस मान कौन कौटी पैसा मिल कथा भी से प्राय जानपर ना तेणु गरीब भारत गरीब संख्या बहुत बेसी ड्यूरिंग 1993 और 94 द प्लानिंग कमीशन एस्टिमेटेड 36% ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन और द 320 मिलियन पीपल लिविंग बिलो द पॉवर्टी लाइन अकॉर्डिंगली देर वर अबाउट 140 टू 150 मिलियन वुमेन लिविंग बिलो द पॉवर्टी लाइन एंड अगेन नाउ इट हैज बीन इंक्रीज्ड टू अ लॉट बट वी डू नॉट नो स्टिल हाउ मेनी वुमेन below the poverty level are living or they are dependent, I mean badly need the financial assistance. So this Rashtriya Mahila Kosh, known as the National Credit for Women in 1993. So here it has been a registered society of the Department of Women and Child Development in the Ministry of Human Resources Development, the Government of India. It has with the corpus of rupees 31 crores with the aim to supplement the effort of the banking sector by fulfilling the gap between the poor and the rich. Poor and the not only rich, but the banking sector offers. So here the Mahila Kosh is actually it's a very, very important organization, particularly for the women in our country. So, unfortunately, no woman goes to this Mahila Kosh because they are somehow they have self-sufficiency, or they manage the funds available with them, or they are try to take the assistance of Mahila Kosh. So these are all the some of the reasons. Comparatively, not only Odisha but all over the India the same position. It is केवल हमर ओडिशा रो दुर्भाग्य बोले हमें कोई चीज नहीं. It is पूरा पृथ्वी रे, including developing countries, विदेश रे भी प्राय कई ये संसारों साझा नियंत्रित नहीं बा सेमान करो पक्को approach करों तो नहीं किंबा संस्था अच्छी भी से जानी नहांती जहाँ फल संस्था ता ना गरीब गरीब ना के क्रेडिट नवार सुविधा सोशल सर्विस कर फायदा एम के नहीं ना नापी भी चाह ना तो प्रमोट रिसर्च स्टडी डिसएनालिसिस ऑफ द रोल ऑफ द क्रेडिट एंड इट्स मैनेजमेंट ये संस्था जरिए आम रिसर्च भी कर परिबा एवं प्रमोशन ऑफ क्रेडिट दार उधार निया दिया एक्चुअली बिजनेस माने कौन बिजनेस माने समस्त तो गोरु ही पैसा आने के बिजनेस करते ना किसी बाध्य बाध्य से माने किसी पैसा पत्र दार करिया को पड़े एवं ताको ही से माने पुनी आस्ते आस्ते सूझी की निजरो संस्था ताको बड़े बड़े कि नेबे तो थे जो इवेन टाटा बिर्ला भी से मैंने जन्म रु ही नोट गदा नहीं आस ना सुना रूपा सांग जन्म ही ना से भी जहाँ पैसा अच्छे बुद्धि खटे आस्ते आस्ते बिजनेस टा को सबुद किसी ना कि उन्नति कर आज ये अवस्था आस पहुँची आम भी जदि आम रूरल वुमेन जो आक्टिव हे ये सब स्कीम विषय जानवे से मैंने भी पुरुष मान सामान हिसाब से विभिन्न रूरल डेवलपमेंट एक्टिविटीज जदि आग को नेबे ताले हुए तो आउ ओडिशा गरीब राज्य है रही आमे कौन सी देश को पैसा पे पैसा अभाव बोली आम कौठ दार उधार भी करिबा ना एंड दिस स्कीम इज मेंट फॉर ओनली लोन क्रेडिट फैसिलिटी It challenged through eligible organization to needy women in a simple, flexible manner without instances on any type of collateral. Actually, eligibility कौनसी इमाने जेतु महिला मैंने individually के आसी परनांती बा SG group माध्यम रे पहुँची परनांती ये महिला कोस कौन करती एकुटी के liberalize कर दी थी कौनसी NGO voluntary organisation कौनसी agency माध्यम ने भी आसी की से मैंने ये facility तो नहीं पड़ी बे विशेष करके आम ओडिशा रे एनजीओ मान को भी विभिन्न काम राज्य सरकार किसी काम एक्टिविटीज दौची एवं लोन भी दौची आ दरकार पड़े से मान को पाए किसी किसी स्कीम्स भी सरकार कर काम गुड़ा भी बैठ से मान को दिया जाओ या व्यक्ति तो जो बैंक गुड़ा ऋण को मैं बैंक जरिया जो ऋण किंबा सब ट्रांजेक्शन गुड़ा बैंक जरिया करती कहीं अकाउंटेबिलिटी रहा एनजीओ मैंने हो सेल्फ हेल्प ग्रुप हो कि कौन से ऑर्गेनाइजेशन सरकार मैंडेटरी कर दे जहाँ जहाँ से पैसा पत्र कारबार हम सब बैंक जरिया हम दे आर अकाउंटेबिलिटी तमें कौन कौन सी वेलफेयर स्कीम बा कौन सी प्रॉफिटेबल काम जो करिया को पड़ियो एटा ट्रांसपेरेंट है कि रहइबो एवं से को क्षेत्र रे केते टंका खर्च करले तार हिसाब किताब भी ठीक ठाक समय पाई जबे और लोन दबा पे महिला कोच रो कौन से देरी भी होबो ने काहे कि ऑर्गेनाइजेशन मान को अति सहज रे दे दबो इंडिविजुअल को देला को तार वेरिफिकेशन करो से सुझी परियो कि नै देई परियो कि नै तार फैमिली बैकग्राउंड कौन सब जेतु कटकणा रहउछि सीधा सड़क गोटे संस्था जरिया रे ए टंका तक गोटे ग्रुप ऑफ इंडिविजुअल दे कैन रेज इट फॉर द बेटर बेटरमेंट ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन तबरे वुमेन्स डेवलपमेंट कॉर्पोरेशन WWDCs एगुडा भी महिला को साथ संगरे एगुडा भी केतबा काम करथंती इमानकर काम हला वोमेन मान विभिन्न संस्था गुड़ा जो गुड़ा अच्छी मेन मेन लोन गुड़ा स्कीम गुड़ा जो गुड़ा अच्छी से गुड़ाक गाइड कर सचेतनता करवा जरिया गुड़े लोन एगुड सब एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन संभापर तीन वर्ष एलिजिबिलिटी लोन अच्छी कि ना कागज पत्र ठीक ठाक करवा एगुड़ा सब हूँ वोमेन डेवलपमेंट कॉर्पोरेशन राम वुमेन डेवलपमेंट कॉर्पोरेशन वन ऑफ द सपोर्टिंग हैंड टू द एसएचजी ग्रुप एंड ऑल्सो महिला कोर्स मेंबर्स एनी वुमेन जेकोसी वुमेन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन जदि किसी करी परुनांती बा आसी परुनांती बा तांको सहयोग जदि से लोडंती ताले वुमेन वुमेन्स डेवलपमेंट कॉर्पोरेशन बोली गोटे संस्था अच्छे जो मैंने कि एमंकर लिंकेज ट्रेनिंग खाता पत्र ये ठीक ठाक रखा आउर एलिजिबिलिटी कौन कले कौन आसो कौन थी कौन पाइबे से गुड़ा सब से दायित्व बुझेगा यह सब कम से करपर सुइटेबल स्टेट गवर्नमेंट एजेन्सी या सांग राज्य किसी एजेन्सी भी अच्छा जो मैंने कि जमी ट्रस्ट गुड़ा है कौन से इनट्यूशन गुड़ा है से मैंने भी वुमेन डेवलपमेंट कमिशन को वुमेन डेवलपमेंट अनुष्ठान मान को साहय जगे दिखती तापर जदि वन लोन इज क्लीयर दे दिज महिला समिति सर महिला मंडल सर एस एच जी ग्रुप दे आर एलिजिबल फॉर अगेन गेटिंग ए लोन वंस द लोन इज ओवर दे कैन गेट द अदर लोन and also maximum amount of loan in case of individual the maximum loan is only 15,000 15,000 tanga kebalo gote individual member ine mahila SG group ba konsi ngo organization re jodi thai se kebalo 15,000 porjanto limitation se paibo au jodi group hela tar seta adhika paisa se paibe gote group re jodi nebe 8 से किस्तिरे तंको सुजियाको पडिबो 36 मंथ्स रे 8 की 10टा क्वार्टरली इंस्टॉलमेंट्स रे से पैसा जको से सुजियाको पडिबो आ एंती ग्रुप रे हेले अधिक पैसा पाइबे द रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट इज आल्सो 8% और समथिंग लाइक दैट तो एबे अवश्य कोन कम बेसी हेतिबो किंतु द मिनिमम परसेंट इन 2005 it was 8%. So it's fluctuating according to the Reserve Bank of India. The interest rate is fixed from time to time. So the margin money to be contributed by the borrowers. Margin money we have to the run out time take time to suddhi gale kichu ta paisa amku chhad kara diye jay tenu se interest to kichu interest free ab pai pariba आउथरे अप्लाई करिया पय भी हमरो इंसेंटिव्स इंटरेस्ट रेट उडा परिवर्तन हे परिबो सो दीज आर ऑल द थिंग्स फॉर द व्हाट इज कॉल्ड द एसएसजी ग्रुप्स ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस वुमेन ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस एंड आल्सो सम ऑफ द एनजीओस दीज आर ऑल रिस्पांसिबल टुगेदर फॉर द डेवलपमेंट लोन प्रमोशन स्कीम्स माइक्रो क्रेडिट फॉर एजुकेशन एंड स्किल अपग्रेडेशन हमें किथे लोन ए माइक्रो क्रेडिट भी पाई परिबा तापरे सपोर्ट फॉर क्रॉप क्रेडिट एंड ऑफ फार्म एक्टिविटीज फॉर वुमेन जेतोले महिला मनकर किथि एग्रीकल्चरल असुविधा किथि जदि हला सेति भी से लोन नै परबे सपोर्ट फॉर स्मॉल कंजम्पशन लोन्स छोटो लोन भी दरकार पड़े से नै परबे तापरे बिल क्रेडिट स्कीम 5 केजी चावल एवडा भी क्रेडिट नै पर इक्वल इंस्टॉलमेंट सो हियर देयर आर सो मेनी स्कीम्स सो वन कैन सर्वाइव द बेस्ट वे दे लीड द बेस्ट लाइफ आउ राष्ट्रीय रोजगार योजना नीड्स लॉट ऑफ अवेयरनेस प्रोग्राम्स provide publicity and nodal agency scheme is also strengthening the hands of the women particularly revolving fund scheme is also there self help groups development scheme is also there and these are all get together we can say is a good sign for the women those are interested in the entrepreneurship so this chapter is completed the self-help groups is actually comparative to other states. Odisha is lagging behind. You will find the self-help groups in other parts of the country. They are very fast and they have almost most of the organizations they have become crorepatis and now they are funding to the political parties and also they are funding to the government bigger projects and they have become one of the part in the and district administration of the state administration so these activities so far the financial conditions are concerned we have to be very careful and every day is important for us for the development so here again we'll name some of the role of the financial institutions in rural development the financial institutions like NABARD is there, IDBI bank is there, and also NSMBC. So these are all some of the agencies. NABARD is National Bank for Agricultural and Rural Development. NABARD, in its name itself, rural development is there. जो NABARD वाले bank का हमारे भवन सर भी अच्छे, सबूत statement कर भी अच्छे. This has started in the year 1980 and a matter of immediate concern is the decline between the 1980 to 1990 and it has worked for the agricultural developmental activities in rural development the major role is the agriculture so if agriculture is strengthened I think the rural development 50% of the problems should be solved and the rural people will be otherwise engaged. And also, the NABARD is one of the banks which gives the financial assistance, timely loans. Financial institutions can go a long way in promoting cooperative self-help and family security. So it is possible to outline the significance of financial institutions in our country's rural development on the basis of the work done so far. When we do that, we notice certain clear landmarks. Perhaps the first thing which strikes us is the contribution of the services provided by the banks. Notable transformation has been witnessed. So here in NABARD is a transactional process of assisting farmers and also financing them at the right time for the right yield for the better production of the agricultural products. So here, domestic products and sometimes the products also related to the export-import also. For all these things, in a broader way, NABARD takes place an active part, monitors, conducts research-oriented analytical reports, data collections, and it interviews the each and every farmer working in different fields, and also the agricultural and developmental process. So this is how the NABARD is one of the leading institutions, financial institutions, which plays an active role in the rural development. And we have it actually was set up as an apex development bank in the year 1982. The NABARD has set up an apex development bank in 1982. The comments of this bank probably solved almost all the difficulties of the farmers. So the bank takes its own interest for the development, all-round development of the agricultural districts. Next comes Industrial Development Bank of India, IDBI. So this has come up with promoting the financial assistance in 1964. It has come in 1964. The bank has started extending microcredit initiative and rural industrial programs, and also it deals with the well known as SIDBI, SIDBI, State Institute of Developmental Banks of India. The IDBI is again grow to be its subsidiary in 1990. So the SIDBI have been created by Act of the Parliament. When we do so, we find both elements continually in the change of operations. Here the SIDBI is again promotion of agricultural industries, khadi village industries, and also some schemes scheduled for the rural promotional schemes, and also Mahila Udyam Nidhi, single window schemes, magnificent rural industries program. Again, it is said be reported to small scale industries sector in 1999. And then comes National Scheduled Cash Finance and Development Corporation, NSFDC. This is actually this has the financial institution, public finance institution, introduced in the year 1989 again, and its basic idea is to provide financial assistance, microfinance initiatives to the scheduled cash developmental through Scheduled Caste Developmental Corporation, and the rural areas rupees 40,000 per annum it was giving to each lower income families as a supportive. So micro credit initiative, the National Scheduled Caste Scheduled Tribe Development Corporation too has schemes of microcredit for lower income scheduled people, and also needs assessment and quality opportunity profiles. So accountability to the beneficiaries. These are all the some of the supporting microfinance institutions where they used to get a lot of facilities. Like that, there are so many other institutions. Actually, the one thing I must make it clear, ये जो संस्था गुड़ा मुझे एबे कही थी, ये गुड़ा केवल इमान के पाएं विशेष करके ग्रामीण उन्नयन कार्यक्रम पाएं ये अनुष्ठान गुड़ा कुआ जाते, या व्यक्ति तो अन्य बैंक नेशनल रिजर्व बैंक सर्वसाधारण फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशंस तापर जो डिपार्टमेंट गुड़ा अच्छी डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंडस्ट्रीज डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एससीएसटी डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ अपना एम्प्लॉयमेंट जनरेशन ये गुड़ा समस्ते पुणी अधिक साय एक्सटेन्ड करेंगे आगे अच्छी मैंने के मना करें ना सो ओवरऑल रूरल डेवलपमेंट स्कीम टा बहुत बढ़िया स्कीम बहुत भल भाव लोक जो जानते जापर जी सचेतनता हो तर विभिन्न स्कीम विषय जो से इनफर्म कराइले स्काइज द लिमिट रूरल डेवलपमेंट गोटे एमती सब्जेक्ट बोधे पूरा भारत में कई गरीब रही गरीब बोली शब्दा ही कौटी सुभव नहीं आपर पैसा पत्र आम जाणीगले सीधा 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 सड़क रास्ता आम कौन कले आम के बची पार एवं बचापी कौ कौ संस्था मान को आम धरवाक पड़ो एवं तुम्हें कमटा को हासिल करने को सब असुविधा हूँ कौन आम जो जगार आमर दाबी अच्छी से आम के जाऊ आम बेकार अगर लोकों पाखे जोरी होता जे कि सुधरे पैसा दब ताक आम दस्तर दौड़ा आज लोन देवाई मना कर शहे थर जापर आम हक अच्छे गोटे ये अनुष्ठान मैंने सब कही यहाँ केवल आम मान अच्छी आम मान मैंने रूराल डेवलपमेंट रो सीधा सड़क संस्था गुड़ा जो मैंने कि कम करमेंगे आम कम टाक हासिल करने को पड़ो तेणु ये सब स्कीम जदि आम जाणी एम सब सरकारी कर्मचारी ही बेस अंतर्भुक्त तेणु आम काम गुड़ा आम क्या ब्रिक मागवा ना आम बर आम पूरा झांपिक नवा जेहेतु आम हक हक अच्छी आम अधिकार अच्छी आम पाई ही ये पांच थुआ ये सब स्कीम गुड़ा मुझे जी कहली ये सब गुड़ा आराम आम गाँव में बस कि सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट दिस चैप्टर नंबर 4 आई हैव ऑलरेडी टॉट यू टू टाइम्स द लास्ट आई मीन द rural basic services and infrastructure. And the infrastructure, I would like to say, tell you only one thing. Jota British amalru jo infrastructure rahi thi ba barsha barsha dhari gaangol re bartan chali asuchi jemti halo kariba bolobot nei ki halo kariba kimba goti fasal barsha ko ame season wise ame chaso kariba आहा अच्छी पुराणा कालिया केवल आम 14 पुरुष चाष करते धान एवं भी आम से सब कनसेप्ट जो आम पछुआ हो जाऊे आम टे चिंता करके जो देखा कौ जमी जमीन कौ फसल भल कि हम ताकू ग्रहण करवा से नूतन पद्धति रिसर्च ओरिएंटेड टाइप रि चाष आम करवा अल्प समय बेसी आमदनी हम फायदा भी हम फाइनेंशियल भी स्ट्रांग हम तापर आम आगे पुराणा ये जुगरे ना हो जे आम जमीन कौ भाया मटी अच्छी ଆଉ କୋଉ ଭଳିଆ ଫସଲ ଆମ ପାଇଁ ଲାଭଦାୟକ, ଏଗୁଡ଼ା ସବୁ ଆମେ ତଥ୍ୟ ଗୁଡା ସରକାରଙ୍କଠୁ ପାଇଯିବା। ତେଣୁ ଏଇ ବିଷୟରେ ମୁଁ ଆଉ ଟିକେ କହିବା ପାଇଁ ଚାହୁଁଛି। ଆଉ ଅନଲାଇନ୍ ମ୍ୟାନେଜମେଣ୍ଟ ଆଣ୍ଡ ମନିଟରିଂ ସିଷ୍ଟମ, ଟ୍ରେନିଂ ଆଣ୍ଡ କ୍ୟାପାସିଟି ବିଲ୍ଡିଂ, ଆମର ଦୁଇଟା ଜିନିଷ ଏଇ ଦିଗରେ ଚିନ୍ତା କରିବାକୁ ପଡ଼ିବ। ଆମେ ଅନଲାଇନ୍ ମାଧ୍ୟମରେ ମ୍ୟାନେଜମେଣ୍ଟ ଆଣ୍ଡ ମନିଟରିଂ, ଅନ୍ୟ ଦେଶରେ କେମିତି ଚାଷ ହେଉଛି ଆମ ଦେଶରେ କେମିତି ହେଉଛି, ଅନ୍ୟ ରାଜ୍ୟରେ କେମିତି ହେଉଛି ଆମ ରାଜ୍ୟରେ କେମିତି ହେଉଛି, ଆମ ପଡ଼ୋଶୀ ଭଲ କରିପାରୁଛି ଆମେ କାହିଁକି କରିପାରୁନାହିଁ, ସେଇ ବିଷୟରେ ତଥ୍ୟ କରିବା ପାଇଁ ଆମେ ମନିଟରିଂ ଦରକାର, ଆଉ ତାପରେ ମ୍ୟାନେଜମେଣ୍ଟ ବି ଦରକାର। ଆମେ ସେଇଭଳିଆ ମ୍ୟାନେଜମେଣ୍ଟ କରିବା। ଆଉ ମୁଁ ଗରିବ, ମୋ ପାଖରେ ପଇସା ନାହିଁ, ମୁଁ କରିବି ନାହିଁ, ଖାଲି ଲାଭ ହିଁ ଦରକାର, ତାହେଲେ ତ ହେଇପାରିବନି। ତମେ ଯୋଉଠି ଅଛ ସେଇଠି ରହିବ, ଯୋଗାଯୋଗ ଧରି ଆପଣ ସେଇଠି ହିଁ ରହିବେ। ତେଣୁ ଏହା ବିଷୟରେ ଯଦି କି ଆମେ ଜମିଟାକୁ ଯଦି ଥିବା ଜମିଟାକୁ ଯଦି ଆମେ ଭଲ ଫସଲ ଚାହିଁବା, ଭଲ ଆମଦାନୀ ଯଦି ଚାହିଁବା, ତା ପାଇଁ ଟ୍ରେନିଂ ଏବଂ କ୍ୟାପାସିଟି ବିଲ୍ଡିଂ ଏ ଦୁଇଟା ଜିନିଷର ବି ଆବଶ୍ୟକତା ରହିଛି। ଆପଣ ଜାଣିନାହାନ୍ତି ଶିକ୍ଷା କମ ଅଛି ବା ଶିଖିନାହାନ୍ତି, ତାହେଲେ ନୂତନ ପଦ୍ଧତି ଗୁଡା ଯୋଉ ଯୋଉ ଆଜିକାଲି ଆସୁଛି ତା ଉପରେ ଆମକୁ ଗବେଷଣା କରିବାକୁ ପଡିବ, ଜାଣିବାକୁ ପଡିବ, ଟ୍ରେନିଂ ନେବାକୁ ପଡିବ। ଯଦି ନିଜେ ଯଦି ଟ୍ରେନ୍ଡ ନ ହେଇଥିବେ ପର ଉପରେ ଆମେ କେତେ ନିର୍ଭର କରିବା, ଆଉ ଜମି ତ ନିଜର, ନିଜେ କେମିତି କଲେ ଭଲ ଆମଦାନୀ ହବ ତା ପାଇଁ ନିଜକୁ କ୍ୟାପାସିଟି ବିଲ୍ଡିଂ ବି ଆବଶ୍ୟକତା ରହିଛି। ନିଜେ କେମିତି ଭଲ ଆମଦାନୀ କରିବ ତା ପାଇଁ କ'ଣ କ'ଣ ଯୋଜନା କରିବାକୁ ପଡିବ, କ'ଣ ସେ ପ୍ରସ୍ତୁତି କରିବାକୁ ପଡିବ, ଏସବୁ ଦିଗରେ ବି ଆମକୁ ଚିନ୍ତା କରିବାକୁ ପଡିବ ଏବଂ ଆମକୁ ସେ ଫାଇଦା ବି ଉଠାଇବାକୁ ପଡିବ। ଆଉ ରିସୋର୍ସ ମୋବିଲାଇଜେସନ, ଆମେ କ'ଣ ଏବେ ସବୁ ଜିନିଷ ଆଭେଲେବୁଲ, ପଇସା ଦେଲେ ସବୁ ଆସିଯିବ, ଆଉ ଆମକୁ ରିସୋର୍ସ ଗୁଡ଼ା ସବୁ ମୋବିଲାଇଜ କରିକି ଆଣିବାକୁ ପଡିବ। କାଲି ଚାଷ ହବ ତା ପାଇଁ ସବୁ ଜିନିଷ ଗୁଡ଼ା ଆଜି ଆମକୁ ଆଣିକି ସଂଗ୍ରହ କରିବାକୁ ପଡିବ। So these are some of the techniques where the research oriented, or you can say mobilization and whatnot, all these things put together is your activity for the better development or the rural development. Okay, this is the closing now. The time is yours. You can ask any question, any doubt. Hello. Hello. Hello.
Sir, Sumit sir.
Subhu ji.
Yes, sir.
Bartan book 3 ta he gala 4 ta bhi mu agru padhe deiche, last gote chapter thila research upare seta bhi he jeiche, aa kichhi doubt ase jodi pochari paribo।
ଆଜ୍ଞା, ଏଇଟା ଟିକେ ସମ୍ ଅପ୍ କରିବେ କି ଟୋଟାଲଟା, ମାନେ ୟୁନିଟ୍ 3 ଟା ଖାଲି ସର୍ଟ ସର୍ଟ ରେ ଟିକେ ସମ୍ ଅପ୍ କରିବେ କି?
କୋଟା 3 ଟା,
ହଁ ୟୁନିଟ୍ 3 ମାନେ ଟୋଟାଲଟା ଖାଲି ସମ୍ ଅପ୍ ଟିକେ କରନ୍ତୁ।
ହଁ, ସମ୍ ଅପ୍ କରି ଦେଇଛି ଅଲରେଡି, ତଥାପି ଯଦି କହୁଛ ଆଉ ଥରେ ମୁଁ କରିଦେବି। ଏଇଥିରେ କିଛି ନାହିଁ, ସବୁ ହେଉଛି ରୁରାଲ ଡେଭଲପମେଣ୍ଟ ର ସ୍କିମ, ବିଶେଷ କରିକି ସରକାରୀ ଯୋଜନା ଯୋଉଟାକି ପ୍ରାଇମ ମିନିଷ୍ଟର ରୋଜଗାର ଯୋଜନା PMRY, ତାର ଅବଜେକ୍ଟିଭ କ'ଣ, ଆଉ ସେ ଏଇ ସ୍କିମ୍ ଟାକୁ କାହିଁକି ସରକାର ଇଏ କଲା, 1994-95 ଏଇ ସ୍କିମ୍ ଟାକୁ ଇଣ୍ଟ୍ରୋଡ୍ୟୁସ୍ କରାଗଲା, ସବୁ 5 ବର୍ଷ ପ୍ଲାନରେ ୟାକୁ ଅନ୍ତର୍ଭୁକ୍ତ କରାହେଇଛି, ଆଉ ଏ ସ୍କିମ୍ରେ ଅନଏଜୁକେଟେଡ୍ ଅନଏମ୍ପ୍ଲଏଡ୍ ଆଉ ଏମାନେ ଯୁବକମାନଙ୍କ ପାଇଁ 18-35 ବର୍ଷର ଯୁବକ ଯୁବତୀମାନଙ୍କ ପାଇଁ ଏଇ ସ୍କିମ୍ଟା କରାହେଇଛି, ଆଉ SC ST ଏକ୍ସର୍ଭିସମେନ୍ ଓମେନ୍ ହେଲେ 45 ବର୍ଷ ପର୍ଯ୍ୟନ୍ତ ବୟସ ସୀମା ଇଏ କରାହେଇଛି। ଏଇ ଚାକିରିଟା ସରପଞ୍ଚ ନିଜେ ତାଙ୍କ ଗାଁରେ ହିଁ ମିଳିବ, ଆଉ ୟାର ଆଗରେ ଥିଲା ଫୁଡ଼ ଫର ୱାର୍କ, ଯଦି ଚାକିରି କାମ କରିବ ସନ୍ଧ୍ୟା ହେଲେ ଧାନ କିମ୍ବା ଚାଉଳ ଡାଲି ଏଗୁଡ଼ା ଦିଆହଉଥିଲା, ଏବେ ତାକୁ ହଟେଇ ଦେଇକି ସିଧାସଳଖ ପଇସା ଦିଆହଉଛି, ସେ ପଇସାଟା ଚେଞ୍ଜ ହଉଛି, ଆଗେ 100 ଟଙ୍କା ଥିଲା 240 ଏମିତି ହେଇକି ସେଟା ମିନିମମ ବେଜ ଆକ୍ଟରେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଯାହା ଅଛି ସେ ପଇସାଟା ଦିଆହଉଛି। ଏଇଟା ହଉଛି ବେରୋଜଗାରୀ ଲୋକଙ୍କ ପାଇଁ ଗୋଟାଏ ବହୁତ ବଡ଼ ବରଦା, କିନ୍ତୁ ଆମେ ମୂର୍ଖ, ଆମେ କଣ କରୁଛୁ ନା କେବେ ବି ଜଣକୁ ଯଦି ଭୋକ ହେଲା ସେ ସିଧା ଲୋକ କଣ କରୁଛି ନା ସହରକୁ ପଳଉଛି କିମ୍ବା ଅନ୍ୟ ଅନ୍ୟ ରାଜ୍ୟକୁ ପଳଉଛି, ସେ ଜାଣିନି ଯେ ତା ଘର ପାଖରେ ଜବାହର ରୋଜଗାର ଯୋଜନା ସ୍କିମ୍ ଗୋଟେ ଅଛି ଯୋଉଥିରେ କି ସେ ବଞ୍ଚି ଯାଇପାରିବ ଏବଂ କିଛି ପଇସା ତାର ଜୀବନ ଇଏ ଶୈଳୀ ପାଇଁ ଆରାମରେ ଚଳିପାରିବ। ତେଣୁ ଏଇଗୁଡ଼ା ସବୁ ରୁରାଲ ଡେଭଲପମେଣ୍ଟର ସ୍କିମ୍, ସବୁଠୁ ଭଲ ସ୍କିମ୍ ହେଉଛି ରୁରାଲ ଡେଭଲପମେଣ୍ଟ। ଅନ୍ୟ ସ୍କିମ୍ରେ କେତେବେଳେ ଲସ୍ ହେଇଯିବ, କେତେବେଳେ ଆମେ ଠିକ୍ ତାର ଫାଇଦା ଉଠେଇ ପାରିବାନି, କିନ୍ତୁ ଭାରତ ସରକାରଙ୍କର ସ୍କିମ୍ ଯୋଉଟା ଅଛି ଆଉ ରାଜ୍ୟ ସରକାରଙ୍କର ବି ଏଥିରେ ପରସେଣ୍ଟେଜ ବି ଅଛି, କିନ୍ତୁ 100% ରୁରାଲ ଡେଭଲପମେଣ୍ଟ ପ୍ରୋଗ୍ରାମ୍ସରେ କ୍ଷତି ନାହିଁ, ଲାଭ ହିଁ ଅଛି। ଯିଏ ଖଟିବ ସେ ପଇସା ପାଇବ, ଯିଏ ଚାହିଁବ ସେ ଏଥିରେ ଯୋଗ ଦେଇପାରିବ, ବୁଝିପାରୁନ? ଆଉ କୋଉ ସ୍କିମ୍ କୁହ। ତାପରେ ମହିଳା କୋଷ SHG ଏଗୁଡା ତ ସର୍ବସାଧାରଣ। ହ୍ୟାଲୋ,
ଆଜ୍ଞା ଶୁଣୁଛି ସାର।
ହଁ, ଆଉ ଅନ୍ୟ ସ୍କିମ୍ ଗୁଡା ଯୋଉଗୁଡା ଅଛି SHG ସେଲ୍ଫ ହେଲ୍ପ ଗ୍ରୁପ ତ ସମସ୍ତେ ଆମେ ଜାଣିଛେ ନା
ଜାଣିଛେ।
ତାପରେ ମହିଳା କୋଷ, ତମେ ଗୁଗୁଲ ସର୍ଚ୍ଚ କଲେ ମହିଳା କୋଷ ଆସିଯିବ, ସେଥିରେ ସେଟା ବର୍ତ୍ତମାନ ଅଚଳ ହେଇକି ପଡିଛି, କାହିଁକି ଏତେ ସୁଧ କଷି ଦଉଛନ୍ତି, କେହି ସେଠିକି ମହିଳା ମାନେ ଯାଉନାହାନ୍ତି, ଇଣ୍ଟରେଷ୍ଟ ପଇସା ବି ନଉନାହାନ୍ତି, ତାଠୁ ବର ବ୍ୟାଙ୍କରୁ ନେଇଯାଉଛନ୍ତି ଘର ପାଖ ଜଣାଶୁଣା ହେଲା। ଏତିକି ଅନେକ ଗୁଡା ସବୁ ମୁଁ ଯାହା ଯାହା ବୁଝେଇ ଏ ସ୍କିମର କିଏ କିଏ କଲେକ୍ଟର ନିଜେ ଗୋଟେ ମେମ୍ବର ଚେୟାରମ୍ୟାନ BDO ଏମାନେ ସବୁ ଅଛନ୍ତି, କିନ୍ତୁ ସ୍କିମଟା ଭଲ, କିନ୍ତୁ ଲୋକଙ୍କର ବୋକାମି ଏଠି ପାଖରେ କାମ କରିବେ ନାହିଁ, ପଳେଇବେ ଦୂରକୁ, ତା ପାଇଁ କିଏ କଣ କରିବ? ଆଉ ଲୋକଙ୍କର ଗୋଟେ ଆଶା, ଇଭେନ୍ ମୋର ତମର ବି ସେଇ ଆଶା ଯେ କୋଉଠି ଯେ ପଇସା ଅଧିକା ମିଳୁଛି ସେଠିକି ପଳେଇବା ହେଲା।
ଆଜିକାଲି
ଅନ୍ୟ ସେକ୍ଟର ବି କରୁଛି ବହୁତ କମ, ତାର ଏହାର ଉଦ୍ଦେଶ୍ୟ ହେଲା କେବଳ ଏଗ୍ରିକଲଚର ମାନଙ୍କୁ ସହଯୋଗ କରିବ, ଆଉ ତାକୁ ତ ସେ ଏଗ୍ରିକଲଚର ରେ ସହଯୋଗ ଇଏ ଫଣ୍ଡିଂ ଦେଇପାରୁନି, ଆଉ ଅନ୍ୟ କୁଆଡେ ଯିବ ସେ ଏଗ୍ରିକଲଚର ମେସିନାରୀ କିଣିବ, ବିହନ କିଣିବ, ତାଙ୍କର ନୂଆ ଯଦି ସ୍କିମ୍ କିଛି ଆସିଲା ତାକୁ ଇଣ୍ଟ୍ରୋଡ୍ୟୁସ୍ କରେଇବ, ଚାଷୀ ମାନଙ୍କର ଦୁଃଖ ବୁଝିବ, କୋଉଠି କ୍ଷତି ହେଲା ଚାଷୀ କି ଋଣ ଦବ, ଏଇଟା ବହୁତ ବଡ ଦାୟିତ୍ୱ କାମ, ସେ କାମ କରୁନାହାନ୍ତି ସେଟା ଅଲଗା କଥା, କିନ୍ତୁ କାମ କରିବେ ତାହେଲେ ସୀମା ବାହାରେ ସବୁ ଚାଷୀ ମାନେ ମାଲାମାଲ ହେଇଯିବେ, ଆଉ କୌଣସି IAS ଅଫିସର ବି ତାଙ୍କ ତୁଳନାରେ ସୁଧଟାକୁ ଇଏ କରିଦିଅନ୍ତି, ବି କରିଦିଅନ୍ତି ମାନେ ସୁଧ ନିଅନ୍ତି ବି ନାହିଁ ଯଦି କ୍ଷତି ହେଇଗଲା ହେଲା। ବ୍ୟାଙ୍କର କାମ ହେଲା ଚାଷୀ ଲସ୍ରେ ପଡିବ ନାହିଁ, ଚାଷୀକୁ ସବୁ ପ୍ରକାର ସୁବିଧା ଦିଆ ହବ ହେଲା, ଆଉ ସେମାନଙ୍କ ଏରିଆ ସ୍ପେସିଫିକ, ଧର ମରୁଭୂମିରେ ଚାଷୀର ଲୋନ୍ ଅଲଗା, ଜଙ୍ଗଲର ଚାଷୀର ଲୋନ୍ ଅଲଗା, ଆଉ ନଈ କୂଳରେ ଚାଷୀମାନଙ୍କର ସ୍କିମ୍ ଅଲଗା ହେଲା। ସେମାନେ ନିଷ୍ପତ୍ତି ନେବେ, ସେ ଚେୟାରମ୍ୟାନ ବଡ ବଡିଆ ସବୁ ବସିକି ନିଷ୍ପତ୍ତି ନେଇକି ତାର କେତେ ଲୋନ୍ କେତେ ସୁଧରେ ଦିଆ ହବ ବା ଋଣକୁ ଚାଷୀକୁ କେତେ ମାତ୍ରାରେ ସାହାଯ୍ୟ କରିପାରିବେ ସେମାନେ ସେଠି ନିଷ୍ପତ୍ତି ନେବେ। ଏଇଟା ଆକ୍ଚୁଆଲି ଡିବେଟ୍ କରେ, ଆଉ ସମସ୍ତଙ୍କୁ ଏକା ପ୍ରକାର ସ୍କିଲରେ ମାପିକି ତ ଋଣ ଦିଆଯାଏ ନା ବା ସାହାଯ୍ୟ କରାଯାଏନି, ଦାରିଦ୍ର୍ୟ।
ଏଇ ଯେ ସାର୍ ନାବାର୍ଡ ଅଣ୍ଡର ମାଇକ୍ରୋ କ୍ରେଡିଟ୍ ଇନିସିଏଟିଭ,
କ୍ରେଡିଟ୍ ତ ମାଷ୍ଟ, କ୍ରେଡିଟ୍ ତ ଦବ ହିଁ ଦବ ହେଲା, ଆଉ କେତେ କ୍ରେଡିଟ କଣ ଦେଇ କୋଉ କେସରେ କେତେ ଦବ ସେଟା ତାଙ୍କର ବୋର୍ଡ ଅଫ ଡାଇରେକ୍ଟର୍ସ ବସିକି ନିଷ୍ପତ୍ତି ନେବେ।
ଠିକ ଅଛି ସାର୍, ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ କ୍ଲିୟର।
आ तमरो असाइनमेंट गुडा देखो असाइनमेंट गुडा जा दबा को थ दे दबो हला
आगे
हां हो ताले हां बाय
थैंक यू सर।